When we look at the sky on a dark, clear night, what do we see? We see the entire sky dotted with countless stars, some bright and some not so bright. The moon is the brightest object in the night sky. The stars, the planets, the moon, and many other objects in the sky are called celestial. That is, they are positioned in or relating to the sky. So these are all celestial objects. Now, when we talk about our planet, that is Earth, our Earth has only one satellite, and that is the moon. Its diameter is only 1/4 that of the Earth. Now it appears so big because it is nearer to our planet than other celestial bodies. The moon completes one orbit around the Earth with respect to the fixed stars in about 27.32 days. That is a sidereal month. The moon takes around 29.53 days to reach the same visual phase, that is the synodic month. The time difference between a sidereal and synodic month is due to the advancement of the Earth in its orbit around the Sun during a sidereal month. The Earth actually travels 30 degrees per month around its orbit. So, the moon must travel not 360 degrees, but about 390 degrees in order for it to realign itself relative to the sun, say new moon to new moon day. Now the time taken by the moon to complete one rotation and one revolution is the same. As a result, only one side of the moon is visible to us on the Earth. It has mountains, plains, and depressions on its surface. These cast shadows on the moon's surface. The moon does not have conditions favorable for life. There is a change in the shape of the moon every day. Sometimes the moon appears to be perfectly round, and sometimes the moon cannot be seen at all, even if the sky is clear. The day on which the whole disk of the moon is visible is known as full moon day. Thereafter, every night, the size of the bright part of the moon appears to become thinner and thinner. On the 15th day, the moon is not visible. This day is known as the new moon day. The next day, only a small portion of the moon appears in the sky. This is known as the crescent moon. Then again, the moon grows larger every day. On the 15th day, once again, we get a full view of the moon. The various shapes of the bright part of the moon as seen during a month are called phases of the moon. Phases of the moon play an important role in our social life. Almost all festivals in India are celebrated according to the phases of the moon. For example, Diwali is celebrated on the new moon day. Buddha Purnima and Guru Nanak's birthday are celebrated on full moon day. Mahashivratri is celebrated on the 13th night of the waning moon. Eid ul Fitr is observed on the day following the sighting of crescent moon. This was about moon, which is the natural satellite. Apart from that, we also have artificial satellites. There are many man-made satellites revolving around the Earth. These are called artificial satellites. They are orbiting around the Earth, and you might wonder how artificial satellites are different from natural satellites. Actually, artificial satellites are man-made. Second, they are launched from the Earth with the help of a rocket, and they revolve around the Earth much closer than Earth's natural satellite, that is, Moon. Now, India has built and launched several artificial satellites. starting from Aryabhatta, which was the first Indian satellite. Some other Indian satellites are INSAT, IRS, Kalpana 1, EduSat, etc. Artificial satellites have many practical applications. They are used for forecasting weather, transmitting television and radio signals. They are also used for telecommunication and remote sensing. While watching the night sky, you may notice various patterns formed by different groups of stars. These are called constellations. Among the constellations, we have Ursa Major. It is also known as the Big Dipper, the Great Bear, or the Saptarishi. There are seven prominent stars in this constellation. It appears like a big ladle or a question mark. There are three stars in the handle of the ladle and four in its bowl. It was one of the original 48 constellations listed by Ptolemy in the 2nd century AD. Today it is the third largest of the 88 modern constellations. Then comes Orion. It is one of the most magnificent constellations in the sky, located on the celestial equator and visible throughout the world. It can be seen during winter in the late evenings. It also has 7 or 8 bright stars. Orion is also called the Hunter. The three middle stars represent the belt of the Hunter. The four bright stars appear to be arranged in the form of a quadrilateral. The star Sirius, which is the brightest star in the sky, is located close to the Orion. To locate Sirius, imagine a straight line passing through the three middle stars of Orion. Look along this line towards the east, and this line will lead you to the very bright star, and that is the Sirius. Cassiopeia is another prominent constellation in the north sky. It is visible during winter in the early part of the night. It is easily recognizable due to its distinctive W shape formed by 5 bright stars. Then comes the solar system. The sun and the celestial bodies which revolve around it form the solar system. It consists of large number of bodies such as the planets, comets, asteroids, and meteors. The gravitational attraction between the sun and these objects keep them revolving around it. The earth, as you know, also revolves around the sun. It is a member of the solar system. It is a planet. There are 7 other planets that revolve around the sun. The 8 planets in their order of distance from the sun are Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, and Neptune. All the 8 planets of the solar system move around the sun in fixed paths. These paths are elongated. Talking about the first, that is the sun is the nearest star from us. It is continuously emitting huge amount of heat and light. The sun is the source of almost all energy on the earth. In fact, the sun is the main source of heat and light for all the planets. The sun is nearly 150 million kilometers away from the earth. The distance between celestial bodies are expressed in light years. It is a distance traveled by light in 1 year. Now remember that the speed of light is about 3 lakh kilometers per second. Thus, the distance of the sun from the earth may be said to be about 8 light minutes. Talking about planets. The planets look like stars, but they do not have light of their own. They merely reflect the sunlight that falls on them. The simplest method of identifying planets from stars is that stars twinkle, whereas planets do not. Also, the planets keep changing their position with respect to the stars. A planet has a definite path in which it revolves around the sun. This path is called an orbit. The time taken by a planet to complete one revolution is called its period of revolution. the period of revolution increases as the distance of the planet increases from the sun. Besides revolving around the sun, a planet also rotates on its own axis like a top. The time taken by a planet to complete one rotation is called its period of rotation. Some planets are known to have moons, satellites revolving around them. Beginning with the first planet, and that is Mercury. The planet Mercury is the nearest to the sun. It is the smallest planet of our solar system. Its orbit around the sun takes only 87.97 days, the shortest of all the planets in the solar system. Because Mercury is very close to the sun, it is very difficult to observe it, as most of the time it is hidden in the glare of the sun. However, it can be observed just before sunrise or just after sunset near the horizon. So, it is visible only at places where trees or buildings do not obstruct the view of the horizon. Mercury has no satellite of its own. Next comes the Venus. Venus is Earth's nearest planetary neighbor. Venus is the second planet from the sun and the third brightest object in the Earth's sky after the sun and the moon. Venus orbits the sun every 224.7 Earth days. Sometimes Venus appears in the eastern sky before sunrise. Sometimes it appears in the western sky just after sunset. Therefore, it is often called a morning or an evening star, although it is not a star. Venus has no moon or satellite of its own. Rotation of Venus on its axis is somewhat unusual. It rotates from east to west, while the Earth rotates from west to east. Venus isn't the closest planet to the sun. It is still the hottest. The reason behind that is it has a thick atmosphere full of the greenhouse gas, that is carbon dioxide and clouds. Then comes our mother planet, that is Earth. It is the only planet in the solar system on which life is known to exist. Some special environmental conditions are responsible for the existence and continuation of life on the Earth. These include the right distance from the sun, so that it has the right temperature range, the presence of water and suitable atmosphere, and a blanket of ozone. From space, the Earth appears blue, green due to the reflection of light from water and landmasses on its surface. The axis of rotation of the Earth is not perpendicular to the plane of its orbit. The tilt is responsible for the change of seasons on the Earth. The Earth has only one moon. Then comes the Mars. So, this is the next planet. The first one actually outside the orbit of the Earth. Mars is a cold desert world. It is half the size of Earth. Mars is sometimes called the red planet. It's red because of rusty iron in the ground. Mars has two small natural satellites, that is Phobos and Deimos. Its orbital period is 687 days. That is, to complete one revolution, it takes 687 days. Indian Space Research Organization launched India's first Mars orbiter mission, that is Mangalyaan, on November 5th, 2013. It was successfully placed into an orbit of Mars on September 24, 2014. With this, India became the first country in the world to do so in its first attempt. Then comes the Jupiter. It is the fifth planet from the sun and the largest in the solar system. It is so large that about 1,300 Earths can be placed inside this giant planet. However, the mass of Jupiter is about 318 times that of our Earth. It rotates very rapidly on its axis. Jupiter has a large number of satellites. It also has faint rings around it. You can easily recognize Jupiter as it appears quite bright in the sky. If you observe it with the help of a telescope, you can also see four of its large moons. At present, it has 79 confirmed moons. Then comes Saturn. Saturn is the sixth planet from the Sun and the second largest in the solar system after Jupiter. It appears yellowish in color. What makes it unique in the solar system is its beautiful rings. These rings are not visible with the naked eye. You can observe them with a small telescope. Saturn also has a large number of satellites, that is 62 satellites. One interesting thing about Saturn is that it is the least dense among all the planets. Its density is less than that of water. Then it is Uranus and Neptune. These are the outermost planets of the solar system and they can be seen only with the help of large telescopes. Uranus is the seventh planet from the Sun. Like Venus, Uranus also rotates from east to west. The most remarkable feature of Uranus is that it has highly tilted rotational axis. As a result, its orbital motion appears to roll on its side. Then it is Neptune. Neptune is the eighth and the farthest known planet from the Sun in the solar system. It is the fourth largest planet by diameter, the third most massive planet and the densest giant planet. The first four planets, that is Mercury, Venus, Earth and Mars, are much nearer to the Sun than the other four planets. They are called the inner planets. The inner planets have very few moons. The planets outside the orbit of Mars, that is Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, Neptune, are much further off than the inner planets. They are called the outer planets and they have a ring system around them. The outer planets have large number of moons. Now, let us learn about some other members of the solar system. The first one is asteroids. Now, there is a large gap in between the orbits of Mars and Jupiter. This gap is occupied by a large number of small objects that revolve around the Sun and these are called asteroids. Asteroids can only be seen through large telescopes. Then it is comets. Comets are also members of our solar system. They revolve around the Sun in highly elliptical orbits. However, their period of revolution around the Sun is usually very long. A comet appears generally as bright head with a long tail. The length of the tail grows in size as it approaches the Sun. The tail of a comet is always directed away from the Sun. Many comets are known to appear periodically. One such comet is Halley's Comet, which appears after nearly every 76 years. It was last seen in 1986. Then it is meteors and meteorites. Now at night when the sky is clear and the moon is not there, you may sometimes see bright streaks of light in the sky. These are commonly known as shooting stars, although they are not stars. They are called meteors. A meteor is usually a small object that occasionally enters the Earth's atmosphere. At that time, it has a very high speed. The friction due to the atmosphere heats it up. It glows and evaporates quickly. That is why the bright streaks lasts for a Earth is called. Some meteors are large and so they can reach the Earth. They can actually strike the surface of the Earth before they evaporate completely. The body that reaches the Earth is called a meteorite. Meteorites help scientists in investigating the nature of the material from which the solar system was